Good morning, friends. Today we are going to see one of the hyphenated technique, that is high performance liquid chromatography. In all, what we are going to learn today is what is the need of liquid chromatography. We know column chromatography can analyze the samples. Then what is the difference, or how the instrumentation and working of this high performance liquid chromatography takes place? How I can go for quantitative analysis? Advantages of the HPLC and applications of HPLC. Now, in regular column chromatographic technique, what we do actually, we take like a burette, we take a column which is filled with the silica, column silica, and we load the sample past the mobile phase, and depending of its partition and retention on silica, that is solubility with the mobile phase, and insolubility, that is the retention with the stationary phase, depending upon that it will try to separate it out. So in classical column chromatography, mobile phase moves slowly through the column by means of gravity. It affects the column efficiencies and long separation time. Now if I operate the mobile phase at higher pressure, it will definitely affect the liquid viscosities to carry out the analysis. So what we are doing, the change over here is we are applying little bit pressure to the mobile phase. Compared to gas chromatography, here in case of gas chromatography, in our first video we have seen how the separation takes place. Now inner layer of gas chromatography, we are using diatomaceous earth particles as stationary phase, over which volatile non-volatile liquid has been adsorbed as an liquid stationary phase. Now when the separation takes place, the solute may adhere on this solid support, and cleaning is a big issue in case of gas liquid chromatography. Cleaning, that means whatever substance has been adhere on the solid support, removing that substance and fresh column ready for the next separation is a big task. Now when we switch over to HPLC as an high pressure or high speed liquid chromatography, this issue of column cleanup is an easy. So that is the need of new technique, liquid chromatography. We'll see in detail what are the components which are going to utilize in HPLC. One is the solvent reservoir. Here you can see a solvent reservoir which has been passed through a pump, that is the pressurized pump. Liquid mobile phase has been pressurized at some known pressure and passed through the HPLC column, which has been kept at particular temperature. This separator components are detected. We can collect here separated component. One of the big advantage, we can collect separated component and the data can be learned or utilized with respect to quantification in software. The first component, that is the solvent reservoir, main component, that is the solvent reservoir. We can do so many changes with this component. We'll see in detail. Now mobile phase is pumped under pressure from one or several reservoirs which are being kept over the column. Here you can see we can kept different mobile phases, we can do the combination. There are various combinations we can do when we are interested in separating the components. One is normal phase, where we are increasing the polarity of the solvent, like we have done this task in TLC2. Well, we are putting a mixture of the component at the baseline and we are interested in separating into the components. We slightly increase the the polarity of the solvent to separate it out with respect to stationary phase and the applied mobile. Same task we are doing over here as an normal phase chromatography. Second one is the reverse phase. What we are doing? Reverse phase. Exactly reverse to the normal phase, where with respect to decreasing polarity of the solvent, we are carrying out the analysis. Next is the isocratic elution, where we are keeping mobile phase as a constant composition. And in case of gradient elution, the composition of the mobile phase varies with respect to pressure. So these are the variations which are very useful in separating out complex mixtures by using HPLC. And another advantage is large number of volatile or non-volatile mobile phases available. Their combinations makes you possible to separate out complex mixture. So routinely used task of HPLC in industry. Second component is pump, where you are pressurizing the mobile phase by using different pumps. So there are two different pumps we are going to see in detail. One is the pneumatic pump, what and how it acts with respect to the mobile reservoir. Now we'll see a solvent is coming from the mobile reservoir from here, and there is a piston. Above the piston some air gap is there, and below the piston also some air gap is there. Now when your mobile phase is coming, the piston drives over the small area and large area. The ratio of these areas amplifies the pressure over the liquid, which will pass towards the column. So that is a simple pneumatic pump, which is very cheap to apply and carry out high pressure chromatographic technique. Second pump which is available is reciprocating pump, where it is actually electrically driven pump, where it acts through the diaphragm. Here you have to electrically apply the pressure, and through the diaphragm it acts over the outlet and inlet valve. Inlet valve here defines the mobile reservoir from where the solvent is coming, and outlet reservoir has been attached to the column, that is HPLC column, where you are applying the mobile phase through pressurized liquid. A constant flow we can achieve in this case, a constant flow through push back and forth action of the piston. Back and forth action of the piston simply through the diaphragm achieves a pressure over here. It is very compact, excellent pressure generates, and it is applicable for isocratic as well as gradient runs, which we have learned in our initial slide. Sample injector. It is the third component. After achieving the mobile phase at pressurized liquid, we have to inject the sample. This particular sample injector we have seen in gas chromatography also, how we are loading the sample over the column and how we can carry out the analysis. It's simply like a syringe where microliters of the sample we can apply. Here you can apply liquid sample as it is, solid sample dissolved in some organic solvent, and gaseous sample purged in a solvent too. So all types of sample we can purge over the column through this small syringe. When you are loading the sample, it has been made in contact with the column. Excess of sample can be removed as a waste, and required sample you can load. How much sample you have loaded is known to you. You can reproduce the result at high pressure through rubber septum. This is an advantage. Now we'll see the fourth component, that is the column. Stainless steel made up of column. You can see in this picture there are a variety of columns available which can withstand high pressure and temperature too. So there are 50 to 300 mm long with inner diameter 2 to 5 mm. These columns can withstand high pressure, filled with a stationary phase of 3 to 10 micrometer inside it. Ideally, the temperature of the mobile phase and column should be kept constant during the analysis. This column has been fit after you are having the inlet pressure. Before the HPLC column, a guard column has been placed. Now we'll see what is the importance of this guard column and why we need to put one more column before the separation column. Here you can see a guard column. Now this is our main column, that is the heart of the instrument where actually the separation takes place. To increase the life of this column, whatever impurities associated with your mixture, with your solvent, can be removed by placing a guard column before HPLC column. It is very short place between the injector and HPLC column. It avoids the damage and loss of efficiency, as it acts as actually a filter before it your sample and components move to the HPLC column for separation. So guard column is a small column introduced before your HPLC column. So these are the components of HPLC. We have seen just now, whatever the solvent reservoir, automated pump which has been attached to the solvent reservoir, then you are having a sampler unit. You can give a programming how you can inject the sample towards the HPLC column. You can do multi-component analysis. This is an HPLC column kept in an oven, a stainless steel which can withstand the pressure, and separated components are passed to the detector unit. You can collect the separated component, that means you can do isolation over here and further analysis of that separated component. You can remove the waste over here. Whatever data obtained, you can process the data towards quantification and qualitative analysis further to find out the concentration of each component. Now, the detectors utilized in your HPLC analysis, there are a variety of detectors available. UV spectroscopy, that is whatever separated component, depending upon its absorbing frequency, you can detect the number of ions and components separated in your compound. Fluorescence detector, where whatever the components are separated, they are being charged, they absorb some amount of energy and the electrons move to the upper phase, and release of energy in terms of fluorescence has been detected as one of the property by using fluorescence detector. Electrochemical detector, which analyzes usually by derivatizing the compounds, and this is a refractive index detector which is routinely used in HPLC for most of the samples, proteins, peptides. After detecting the sample, the data has been collected as a response of detector to each compound on a chromatogram, which we can easily read and interpret. Quantitative analysis of the data obtained on chromatogram, like we have seen in gas chromatography, we will come to know how many compounds are there. Here we can easily interpret the data that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 compounds. To do the quantitative analysis, we should have to have good resolution. Resolution defined here, separation of peak. Response of the compound should be linear to the detector. There should be good peak performance. That means there should not be telling effect, overlapping of the peaks. Good performance. Some peak symmetry should be there. So now the question is on our mind, which is this the fifth compound which is having large proportion? We can do quantitative analysis of this particular area under the peak, and we can compare the peak. If the we are interested in knowing which compound is there, we can introduce, once we have analyzed, we can introduce some standard solution into it, whose peak area, if it matches, we can compare the response time, the retention time, and you can see that this is the compound present in my given sample. By comparing the data, or we can say standard addition method, we can gather the data from HPLC column, that is resolution. We can measure the resolution, separation quality of your two peaks, measure by measuring retention time of these two peaks, and we can measure the width at baseline of these two peaks, which is easily detectable and find out at the base peak. So that is your resolution factor, TR2 minus TR1 divided by 0.5 into bracket W1 plus W2, that is the width at baseline. We can find out column efficiency, that is number of theoretical plates. We can calculate by knowing this formula, n equal to 5.54 into bracket TR divided by W at half the width height bracket square. TR is the retention time of particular analyte of your interest. Width of that particular peak at half height, which enables us to measure the number of theoretical plates. One more factor you can calculate over here, that is the capacity factor. It is measure of retention of peak, that is independent of column geometry and mobile flow rate. We can measure capacity factor. Now, how we can measure capacity factor? That is, T0 is nothing but the dead time of the column, that is point of injection of your sample. and this is the retention time of your particular pin. So TR and T0, these two parameters, if you able to know, you can able to calculate the capacity factor of your compound. So looking at the advantages of HPLC, we can carry out the separation very fast, efficient. Continuous monitoring of the column we can do by looking at the pressure, by changing the mobile phase, looking at the parameter of chromatogram, whether my compound is separating or no. I can do that monitoring by changing the program and achieve the better separation or resolution. Analysis of very complex mixture can be possible. Repetitive reproducible data I can do. I can analyze, I can save the data. I can do method development, automation of analytical procedures. We can do that, which are useful in pharmaceutical industry. Once any particular tablet has been formed, we can do the automation and data handling. We can give the analytical method development procedure for that particular company. If they applies that particular pressure mobile phase, we can analyze the data. HPLC is more versatile compared to GC. A variety of column packings are available. Here we can do both aqueous and non-aqueous samples. Aqueous samples and non-aqueous samples too, that is organic samples. Separated components can be easily collected, isolated from the mobile phase for further analysis. We can do multi-component analysis. In one of the graph we have seen, the five compounds has been separated. Analysis of the components is not limited to their thermal stability. Normally the analysis is completed in few minutes with excellent precision and accuracy. There are applications, there are wide applications of HPLC. We can do qualitative, quantitative analysis. We can do the analysis on large scale in pharmaceutical industry, that is R&D, research and development unit, routinely use this technique for their products to analyze the concentration like aspirin, ibuprofen, paracetamol, salts like sodium chloride, potassium phosphate, organic chemicals like polymers, protein like egg white or blood protein, heavy hydrocarbons like asphalt and motor oil. We have seen there in GC that we can do the hydrocarbon analysis in gasoline, and this is your last product, very high hydrocarbon content asphalt, that we can do over here. Isolation of natural product, a big task. There is very difficult task to isolate a compound from any medicinal plant. Here we can do that isolation of naturally active compounds in herbal medicine. Thermally unstable compounds also like trinitrotoluene, TNT, we can carry out their analysis over here. And this technique is routinely used in clinical chemistry too. Thank you. Hope you have enjoyed and understood the HPLC technique. Please share, like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.